Can I add one other cool thing about this? To work out this constant, we used a fundamental fact about prime numbers. It was called Bertrand's postulate, where the prime number is always between the previous prime and twice the previous prime. What we've done here works for any sequence of numbers where Bertrand's postulate is true. Imagine a sequence of numbers where it's limited between the previous number and twice the previous number. The way this is worked out with this formula and these properties will always work for any sequence that follows Bertrand's postulate, not just prime numbers. What else could we do that's similar to that? Here's an easy one. So what about this sequence? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, these are just integers bigger than 2. But you can see it follows Bertrand's postulate. You know, they're getting bigger. They're always less than double the previous one. And you can do the same thing. There is a constant that will generate this sequence. Same formula, different constant though. And the constant that generates the integers is, we'll call it F1, is E. Euler's number. Euler's number with the formula will generate the integers. It's an integer generating constant. Surprise! And
that's amazing.
It's great, isn't it?
Is it the only one? Like, is it the one? Is it the only one?
I'm going to say yes, I think so. Off the top of my head, I'm saying yes. It's going to be the only constant that generates it in this method. We're going to have many integer generating constants in the same way there are many prime generating constants. But in this method, yeah, it's lovely, isn't it? E comes out. It also means there's a sequence where the average is E as well. The same way I had that sequence before, we were looking at primes, the smallest prime that doesn't divide n. What about the smallest integer that doesn't divide n? So we're just replacing the word primes with the word integer. And that sequence, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 3, very similar, but of course we're not limited to primes now. And so the constant has changed, and that constant is Euler's number E.
Oh, wow. Talk about burying the lead.
So, surprise E.